Hi guys, welcome to Miraki the Tribe. My name is Ayushi and I'm bringing you a random reading. This is something that I'm recording on 7th of November 2018, but this will apply to whenever you are watching this video. And by the way, today is Deepavali, so I'm from India and right now people are celebrating Diwali while I'm doing this reading. I just felt like doing a reading and I wanted to feel connected to what I do and I wanted to just do it. And I wanted to share it with my people who are subscribed to me on my channel. So let's see what's coming up. So we have a stack here. The Hangman, Five of Swords, Three of Pentacles, Six of Wands, the Emperor, Ace of Pentacles, the Empress. I'll pull out one more card. By the way, bottom of the deck energy right now is the Ace of Cups. I'll also pull out the clarifiers. So let's see, give me one more card. What are the energies coming in for Deepavali, basically for the people who are watching this video? What are the messages that are coming in right now? So in India, today is actually a new year. So according to the Hindu calendar, it's new year today, and we celebrate Deepavali because today is the day when our Lord Rama, he returned from exile. After 14 years of exile, he returns to his kingdom, which is Ayodhya. And by the way, I am from Ayodhya. If some of you, actually nobody knows, so I'm originally from Ayodhya. I don't live in Ayodhya, but I am actually from Ayodhya. So yes, so that's his birthplace, and I know Ayodhya. Oh god, by the way, the card which is coming out again is which was the bottom of the deck, the Ace of Cups. So yeah, Ayodhya is like currently in a lot of controversy because of Hindu-Muslim communal divide, but it's mostly politics. There is no as such Hindu-Muslim divide like in day-to-day life. It's just political hype. But yeah, the place is still surrounded by controversy. You can look it up on Google if you want to. And then we have the Hierophant and the Justice card. So these are the two extra cards that came out. By the way, bottom of the deck is a very beautiful card, which is the Sun card. So I'm going to say a few zodiac signs which are coming up in this reading. Leo, Sun Moon Rising, Pisces, Sun Moon Rising, Aries, Sun Moon Rising, all the Earth sign, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn, mainly Taurus, all the water sign coming up, water sign, Scorpio, Cancer, Pisces, and then Taurus again, and Libra. So in this reading, it's a very positive reading as far as I can see, because there is only one card which is not so likable. It's Five of Swords, which is having a conflict, internal conflict or conflict with people around you. This can be a futile argument that you are having. Like, there is no end to this argument, there is no head or tail to this argument, there is no reason why you are having this argument or conflict. It's just that somebody is trying to satisfy their ego. They want to win this battle or argument just for the sake of it. But it's not something like this person might even lose their relationship with the other person that they are arguing with, but they will keep on presenting their argument just because they have to win it. By the way, if you are hearing noise like crackers, that's because people are celebrating Diwali. And yeah, so let's see. I'm going to pull out some clarifiers, like I said. So we do have a lot of major arcana in this reading, which is the Hangman, the Emperor, the Empress, the Hierophant, and the Justice card. So I'm with the Emperor and the Empress coming out together with the Ace of Pentacles in between. I'm seeing that there is, if you are starting a relationship today, which is with someone new, It's going to be very long lasting, and it can even end up in marriage because you have the Hierophant. And because we do have Justice card here, if you are experiencing some sort of a separation or divorce, it is final, like it is final, and you will now have to start a something new, because this is the indication that justice has prevailed and karma has been settled. And today is a new moon in Scorpio, so there is something new starting as it is, and old deep things, like old emotions, deep emotions that you have been holding on for a very long time. And by the way, I was looking up to some astrological, you know, planetary changes and all that. I feel that I have heard it, and I'm just gonna say it, like some of you who are especially Cancer sign or rising or water sign, or generally if you remember what you did in the year 2000 or 2001, that could be very relevant. How you felt back then? Were you ignored as a child, or were you bullied as a teenager? Whatever it is, how awkward were you when in your teenage life, and what did you learn from that phase? What things have changed, and how you feel about yourself now? Those things are going to come into picture, like how you felt back in 2000. That energy is coming back again, and you have to just understand how you have grown from that phase, how you felt with your mother, or how do you feel about your upbringing, your childhood issues, basically they can come up. How have you able to resolve those issues in past few years while growing up? Those things are coming up prominently at this point of time. That's astrologically, not according to the tarot. According to tarot, I'm getting here that if you're looking for someone new, if you are not, then yes, the answer is that you have to leave the if you are hanging on to somebody from the past, that's not gonna be good for you, because Ace of Pentacles with Ace of Cups, it marks the new beginning, and it is also a very long lasting new beginning. Like whoever you choose right now, that's going to be long lasting. And so make sure that you're not choosing somebody who with whom you are, you have a certain sort of a pattern which is toxic. So it's very essential that if you're thinking about losing somebody who has not been serving their end, and who hasn't been keeping up with you, who is not equally involved, or who hasn't shown you a lot of promise, it's time to let this person go, because I think you are in conflict about something, starting with somebody. That's it. That is what is coming up, because we have the Three of Pentacles. This is also a card where you want to make it work with people, like people around you, or somebody wants to work it out with you. But mostly it's coming up as like an ego battle. Like this person might come and tell you that they want to work it out with you, but actually what they want is that they want to win. Like they just want to feel like they have, like, you know, they still have your attention. That's the feeling that I'm getting. And I'm getting that you do have a lot of things to offer to yourself. Or I'm also getting that your parents, if you have father figure or mother figure, they may or may not be your parents, but whoever is your father figure or a mother figure, they are very much present in your life, and they are offering you tremendous gifts, like beautiful gifts. They have a lot to offer you, and you will have to treat them like, you know, like they know a lot. You will have to give them that sort of respect. That is when you will be able to see the opportunities, how you can interact with them, and how you can open new doors with them, not going against them. You have to open doors with them, with their blessing, with their consent. I don't usually get these sort of messages, but I'm getting them right now. So I'm going to say that please pay attention to it, because we have the Sun, which is the Leo. So right now we have shifted from North Node to, by the way, I'll show you the cards somehow. This is the reading. Okay, so this is the Sun card. So North Node was in Leo, and now it's shifting to Cancer. This is the Cancer card. So this is the bottom of the deck. throughout this transition, I think you have to be very, very patient with yourself, because you are moving from some sort of realization to making a move because of that enlightenment or that realization. Both of these are major arcanas, so it's a big, huge shift. This is a new beginning. This is a new beginning. Ace of Pentacles, Ace of Cups, and then the Emperor and the Empress, which is telling me that if you are with somebody right now, you are a power couple, Emperor and the Empress. It's beautiful. And in fact, you can also feel like you have a spiritual connection, either with this person or because of this person, you are having a spiritual awakening. Because that's the kind of impact that they are having in your life. Now, what I'm also getting here is that at workplace there is some conflict, but you will be victorious in the end. This is either you are leaving your work where you have been thinking about leaving something behind. Like, I'm mostly getting it's work, or it can be a relationship where you were trying to work it out, but now you have to liberate yourself. You're deciding to liberate yourself because things have not been working out, and you have realized your true self-worth, and you are asking for something new, something that you truly know that you do deserve. This is somebody who is very aware of what they have to offer and what they do deserve. This person has a very high self-esteem. So yes, I'm also getting that you might have discovered that you are self-sufficient and you need to have control and power back into your life. You are taking away your power from something where you felt very, very stuck. This is somebody stuck. You were stuck in a very dark place for a very long time, is the feeling that I'm getting. And since then, you have, because of that dark phase that you went through, you had a realization. This, and now you have realized that you have to stand alone and you have to be okay with it, because that's when you can be entirely free, and you can, that's when you can offer somebody that you, what you have got, and without being dependent on them, without expecting anything in return from them, because you have so much, and nobody can take it away from you. You will only grow from here. You are not losing anything by offering other people, because you have discovered a treasure within yourself. I'm also getting that because these two cards came out as extra cards, I'm getting that there is something spiritual happening, like a awakening for some of you, where you are realizing that you have cleared your debt, you have cleared your karma, and you are very happy about that, and you want to talk to people about it, how you have overcome challenges in your life, and you really, really want to share your experiences so that other people who are struggling with the same thing, they can start getting rid of their karma, or they can easily move out of their karma without resisting it. But what I'm going to suggest here is that don't do it. If people are not asking for your advice, don't do it. That's you might be interrupting their karma, so don't interrupt, don't go that way. Let me just clarify. Kindly clarify the Hierophant and the Justice card. Some of you will divorce, definitely. Like, it's this is the court, the judge, and this is the marriage card. So either you are getting married or you are getting divorced. Something related to court. If it's marriage, you are starting something new. Like I said, it's going to be very long lasting. But you will have to be very patient with, how you deal, how you grow this relationship, and how you can still maintain your identity, how you still have your own power within yourself and do not give it away, do not fall into that codependent thing again. So, or you can be just liberating yourself from the marriage that was not working out, and there was a lot of conflict in that and you felt very stuck in that relationship. So you might be liberating yourself, and now you will move to something new in your life, okay, where there is an equal match, people, Emperor and the Empress, where there is an equal match, abundance and happiness. Okay, I'm just going to keep this here. just give me two advice cards. This is a Deepavali reading. Okay, so first card out is the Eight of Pentacles, very nice. And bottom of the deck is the Two of Pentacles, Eight and Two makes Ten of Pentacles, which is a very prosperous family and legacy card. Like Ten of Pentacles is the best card that you can have for stability and prosperity and abundance. But right now you don't have Ten of Pentacles. Did I say Ten of Cups? I meant Ten of Pentacles, okay? So, right now you don't have Ten of Pentacles. What you have is the Eight of Pentacles with Two of Pentacles. So, you are trying to work it out. You know, you are trying to balance your life, your personal and professional life, your relationship with your work. So, you're trying to keep a balance, or you have a two job to, you know, to work, and you're trying to maintain a balance, and you're doing it very, you know, successfully. This person is very focused on what they are doing, and they are doing it very successfully. And then you have Eight of Pentacles, where you are working really, really hard. This person is working really hard. Every day this person goes to work and puts their head down, and you know, they are just doing same thing again and again because they want to achieve some sort of perfection, or they just want to be focused on their work because they know that right now it's their time to work. If they want to have results, positive results in future, this is their investment. This is the work that they have to put in order to get to the sun, which is success, happiness, recognition, promotion, prosperity. So first you have to put in the work, okay? Give me one more advice card. What are the messages for New Year and Deepavali reading, whoever is watching this video? What is the advice for whoever is watching this video? New Year reading for people who are watching this video. One card. One advice card, please. Okay, we are getting a lot of cards, but I'm gonna take this one. Knight of Wands, and I feel like taking all these. Okay, so we do have a Ten of Pentacles coming up. In fact, I was wondering, what if I get Ten of Pentacles in this reading? That would be nice. And we did, like, we are getting it. So this is suggesting that if you keep putting in this work that you have to do, you will reach this happy family, prosperous, abundant family life, health, and you know, all the investment in the right places, good saving. This is the card which is coming up, which is nice. So this is a very nice family card. So you, if you put in the work, you will get this. This is the assurance, reassurance, because you must have faith in your work. But this Knight of Wands is someone who's trying to come and distract you. Okay, this Knight of Wands is someone who is coming to distract you from your work. This person comes and goes, and how you will, you know, I think you will feel a little bit, you know, emotional when it comes to this person. And you're looking down on your cup, you're like, okay, so this is how I manage my emotion. But I see that you will turn your back towards this person who is very inconsistent in your life. This person is saying a lot of things, but they are not doing anything promising, or they are not committing. So you are very in, like, you know, you're very focused on your cup. You're like, are my emotions worth investing in this inconsistent situation where this person comes and just disrupts my work, my focus? So you're asking yourself, is it worth it? Is it worth it? And then again, you are reminded of your beauty, your abundance, your capability, your self-worth. You are being reminded. This is the same Empress card where we had this card, which is the same card. So very important for you is to remember your, you know, your own true value, and not sell yourself short. Don't feel like you don't deserve any, you know, anything good or whatever. If that's the thing playing in your head, that you don't deserve a good life, that's this card is saying that kindly do not doubt yourself. and what you can achieve and what you have to offer to the world and your place in the world. So recognize this person, this higher self within you, and try to manifest and become this person with all your intensity, very, very focused, very much in control of your emotion. Don't get swayed by your emotions. Just put in that effort. This is the right time to start building something new, because you have things coming up which are promising you so many things. The sun, ace of pentacles, and growing into a empress. Ace of pentacles will require you a lot of patience when you are trying to plant a seed. You're trying to grow a tree. This is the seed, this is the tree. So it will take time to grow, but it's worth investing. Okay, bottom of the deck is very surprising. Another emperor card, which is this card, emperor. Both these cards are emperor. I'm so glad I'm able to put the camera like this, because earlier when I used to do readings, I was not able to set my camera like this, and I used to feel like maybe people will not believe when cards come up like this. But it's not, you know, it's not coincidence. These things are meant, like, you know, this synchronicity. People should believe in these things because it happens. Like, you know, the emperor coming up again, emperor, it's validating the reading. It's reassuring you that if you will work, then things will work out for you. This is not a, you know, I'm not pulling out cards all by myself. These are coming out on their own. So emperor, empress, you come up with empress again. And then when we had the eight of pentacles, we had two of pentacles again. And then we eight and two equals to ten of pentacles. So if you are able to balance something in your life, and if you are able to multitask, you will end up with a very happy and luxurious life, and your family will be happy. And ignore this person, whoever this is, trying to create confusion and trying to disrupt your focus. And there is some separation in your life that you have to understand. There are things which are black and white. People are toxic and some people are blessing. So who is who, you have to determine it. And you don't have to take toxic people back into your life. Cut these people out of your life who are causing you conflict. When we had the sun card, as soon as we had the sun, which is the Leo card, we have the chariot here. Cancer and Leo, we are shifting from Leo energy to Cancer energy with shifting of our north node. So anyway, let's focus on the emperor. So this is saying that take back your power, take back control into your own hands. Do not let other people lead you. Don't let these things, like, my father said this, so I did this, my mother told me to do this, so I did this. Take control and responsibility of your life. You cannot just blame other people. You cannot keep blaming other people that my environment is not good, my family isn't supportive, and this and that. No, that way you will just keep getting stuck in the same place and with the same excuses for the rest of your life. Do you want to be stuck? Ask yourself, why am I stuck? Why am I stuck? Ask yourself that. By the way, the most important energy here is the Seven of Pentacles, which is showing a lot of patience, showing a lot of courage and patience while you are trying to grow into a person that you want to be. So if you have to guys, I'm really sorry about the crackers, so the noise of the crackers. Basically what I'm trying to tell you is that if you are trying to build something, you have to keep your patience. Like if you look at my channel, initially when I started this channel, which was back last year in August, I struggled a lot. I was never introduced to tarot before in my life ever. One day I just bought the cards. I don't know how I bought them. I bought it in April. Then I did not use it. I don't even know how to do a reading. Kept sitting in my, you know, I'll tell you why I bought the cards. I bought the cards because I watched one of the tarot reading, and I was like, wow, these cards look so beautiful, and I would want to have a deck for myself just for the fake of it, because I love, this is my first tarot deck, by the way. This is Wild Unknown. So I was like, I really like, I'm a very artsy, crafty person, so I was attracted to the card itself, and I was like, I'll buy it and I'll keep it. Nothing major. And by the way, I was at that point of time, I won't say I'm over that point of time. Okay guys, there is a train that is going to pass. Yeah, so back then I was, you can say I was in the worst phase of my life. I was thrown out of my house, and I had to go through a lot of humiliation and dark night of the soul, whatever you can call it, and some sort of spiritual inclinement. Like, I was inclined towards spiritual processes of some sort. I can't go in detail about that, but yeah, and I was going through some emotional and even physical ailments. I was not able to get up. I was lying in bed for months. I was not able to move my body, and I had a lot of deficiencies and stuff like that. Endless things. So what happened was, I bought the deck back in April 2017, I guess, and yes, 17. Yeah, 17. So it kept sitting on my shelf, and then in August I just switched on my camera, which was not on laptop, because my laptop does not support a camera right now. I have an external camera that I'm using right now, but that point of time I went to webcam toy. If you know, any of you know, webcam toy is, I guess, a website. So I went there and I recorded a video, and then I had to download that video on my laptop, and then I had to again upload that video on YouTube. So it was a very lengthy process, like go on webcam, record the video, and sometimes that video even got lost, like I was not able to save it, and network was not that good and stuff like that. So I just did it on a whim, and I didn't mean to do it, I was not planning to do it, but it just happened. Like, one day in August I got up and I did it, and then since then I just started doing my videos. And if you can see, I don't have a lot of followers. Sometimes it bothers me, but then I keep getting reminded of the fact that when I started doing these videos, I'm not very confident coming in front of the camera, so I had to overcome that hurdle. Like, I'm not comfortable sitting in front of camera and talking to people, because I'm an introvert by nature, and so that was a something that I don't know how I did it, and I had to like come out of my comfort zone. And then I'm not too comfortable with speaking English, if you can notice that. Then I had to be okay with that. I'm a perfectionist, so it was not easy for me to be okay with the fact that I'm not good with my, you know, delivery and language and stuff. So I had to be okay with that. And then I had set an intention that whoever I interact with through this channel, I want to have a very close bond with that person. Like, you know, whoever it is who is coming to me, I want to you know, I have named my channel as Meraki the Tribe, so I want to treat everyone who comes my way through this channel with a lot of, you know, like they are my friend. Like, even though we will never meet, but this person is my friend, and this person is someone I know very closely, because this person is my tribe, this person is my family. So I wanted to treat everybody like that. Actually, the backstory is that I never could make any friend in my surrounding. So I've been good with virtual friendship and stuff like that. So I was like, maybe this will work out for me, and I'll be able to reach out to people and, you know, make friends, and as well as help them get through things that even I was going through in the past. So that's how I started the channel. And because of that intention, I had very clearly mentioned to myself, like, I don't want a lot of followers, but whoever comes into my channel, whoever becomes the part of the tribe, Meraki the tribe, that person, like I wanted that person to come and stay, like it's their family and like it's their community. So I just want to have a community, I want to raise a community, I want to be a part of that community, I want to be a part of, you know, a family, and you guys are my family is what I'm trying to say. So even though this channel did not grow as much as I would have liked, it's been more than a month, more than a year, and I don't have many followers, but whoever is added on my channel, I think they are very precious to me, and some of the comments that I get, I feel very touched, and I feel like, you know, you guys are connecting to me, and that's very important for me. Whenever I'm feeling down, it doesn't happen often, but whenever I'm feeling down, some day or the other I'll get a very random comment, and even if it's one line, I feel like, okay, it's worth it, like I'm doing something that, like, you know, even if I get even one comment, I'm like, okay, somebody noticed that video and took something from that video, and I reached out to somebody in certain corner of the world and connected with that person, and that's why they took out time to write me that comment. Otherwise, why would they have? Because there are millions of video, and basically why I'm sharing this is because once you start to build something, there will be a few things that you will have to overcome, come out of your comfort zone, do it because your heart is asking you to, do it against all odds, don't try to be perfect, and have a lot of patience. You might not get success in 2 months, 3 months, or a year, or I don't know, but at least you are doing something that you are proud of, at least you are doing something that satisfies your soul, that makes you who you are, and you are doing something probably that you always wanted to do, but you were not able to do because you were not getting approval of other people or even your own approval. So be attached to your work and treat it in a very sacred way is what I'm feeling here, and it's not a chit chat. Please don't feel like, you know, I'm delivering the chit chat sort of a video here. I'm actually talking about my experience because I want to actually make, you know, connect with you, and I want to put this message across, like how things happen. I'm not saying I'm a huge success, but I don't regret it. I don't regret it, and I have found myself through this work that I'm doing, and I might be good at 10 million other things, but I haven't discovered that yet. Maybe someday when I'll discover that, then I'll shift to that work if I'm good at that, like better than this. But until then, I'm going to be doing this, and I'm going to improve myself. And I don't want to be, you know, somebody who is the expert or the pro. If I'm doing my work and I'm learning something, it's worth doing it. It's worth learning something new. It's worth learning something constructive. It's worth learning something that you know nobody else can do apart from you. I used to hate myself because I was very emotional. I'm still very emotional. I get emotional. If I watch a scene, not even an entire movie, if I watch an ad, advertisement, which is a little bit sentimental, I'll just start crying. And a lot of things used to make me, you know, emotionally very, I'm very unstable when it comes to emotions. Not many people want to be around me because my emotions just keep fluctuating. But this is how I discovered that I can put my emotions to use by connecting to people who want to be heard, who want to be guided, who want to be, you know, who want a friend, who, I don't know if I'm doing a reading. To be very honest, I'm not sure how I do the reading. I just do it. Mostly it's somebody communicating through me. I know that I'm not communicating because I did not start doing this video because I wanted it. It just started to happen through me. So I'm not going to take the credit. But what I do know is that I want to be here for somebody who wants me here. And So I hope you discover something that in yourself. I was watching a video today, and Jay Shetty video, something like that, his name is Jay Shetty. He was saying that you have to answer 4 questions in order to discover what your passion is and what you should truly do in your life. For example, the first question is, what are you good at? What do you love doing? What do people around you need? What does the society need or the community around you need? And how can you make money doing that? So whatever you love to do, whatever you want to do, and what people require, like the what the society requires, you have to fill that gap. And how you can make money doing the thing that you love to do, which will contribute to the society, you have to figure that one thing out. What is that thing that you are good at, that you love doing, and you would like to make money doing that thing, particular thing, and people can actually make use of that thing. So what is that one thing? Discover in yourself. If you don't have it, learn it. Skill yourself. Learn something that will add to your skill. And I hope you find that thing, because I know it's not everybody finds their talent or their gift. Some people have to develop it. I feel I have to develop it. For example, I know I landed into tarot out of nowhere, but working on my communication, working on my presentation skills, which I'm not really good at. You can, like, this background that I have done was a big deal for me, because as you have seen, like, I have a very pretty random backgrounds, and it's also mostly due to because I'm pushed from one place to another. Like I said, things are not really good at my place, so I have to adjust to all that. And then I had to work on so many other things. If you can understand, I cannot explain everything here, but what I'm saying is that you will be shown a gift, but work you will have to do. Persistence, you will have to go through all that, you know, you will have to persevere. That's not something somebody else is not going to come and do it for you. So discover what you really like and start building on it, and be patient with yourself. You are not going to, you know, get the jackpot on day one. It will require you a lot of effort, but you will reach there. Definitely, you will reach there. Just have faith in yourself. I will pull out one last card, very random, just because I have been going on and on and on, and I just want to end it with a oracle card. Give me guidance. Okay, we have 2 here. Facade. So if you are telling yourself a story which is outdated, where you have been telling yourself, I'm not like this, I'm like that, I never do this, I do that, I cannot do this, and it's not my, I cannot do something. If you're telling yourself a story which is outdated, which is boring, which is not serving you, drop it. Drop it. If you are engulfed by your ego and you're not able to tell yourself, no, you are stupid in some ways, and accept it. Yes, I have been stupid in my past. So accept that and stop pretending to be smart when you are stupid in some cases, and start learning, because that will help you more instead of pretending that you know things. So drop something that is not serving you. It can be your ego, it can be your emotional story. This thing happened to me, that's why I'm like this. I wasn't raised well, that's why I'm like this. Okay, so yes, you had a pretty bad childhood. I had that too, and I still go through a lot of stuff even today because of that. But you have to change the narrative in your mind. You have to basically tell yourself a different story. Like, okay, so I had a bad childhood, but from now on, I'm gonna give myself all the attention that a child required back then, and I will treat myself really well. I'll give myself what I need, and I'll focus on my well-being, be there for yourself. So start doing something about your sad story. Make it happy. and then you have balance. The balance card is about while you do that, maintain some balance. Give me a moment. There is some grief here. So some of you are not able to let go of a certain situation which has been very sad and depressing. So I'm not saying that get over it today, but maintain balance between slowly trying to let go of something that was not serving you and at the same time start investing your focus and energy into something that you do need in your life. So don't get carried away by grieving too much, and don't get carried away by ignoring your emotions and becoming a workaholic. Try to keep a balance. Don't do anything just because you like to do it the way you want to do it, by making other people sad. Sometimes you have to draw that boundary that you don't have to please everybody, but don't take it too far. Don't hurt people just because you can, and just because you are hurt, so you are trying to hurt other people. Don't do that. But at the same time, do not engage with people who have hurt you in the past. Try to push them away, tell them that you don't have time for them, or that you have some other thing to do and you are busy. Just let them know that and move away in a polite way. Actually, I'm getting disturbed because of the crackers, so now I'll take your leave. And I know not many people will watch this entire video, because I have been blabbering a lot in the last 30 minutes. So guys, I hope this video was helpful for some of you, and in case it wasn't and I wasted your time, I'm sorry guys. And that's what, I did not plan to do this, but this is what this video was about. And I'll see you guys again. Happy New Year once again, and Happy Diwali all of you. Take care.